between the ages of 10 to 16. Scoliosis will affect around 4% of children, especially developing pre-teenage girls. When it comes to handling this spinal condition, early diagnosis and bracing treatments can delay or even prevent surgery altogether.
Scoliosis is defined as a lateral deviation of the spine as well as a rotational component. So it has those two characteristics.
From the side, we have these curves, right? Natural curves, our lordosis and our kyphosis. But from the front and from the back, you can see it's a straight line, right? So if you have scoliosis, you're going to see deviation off of that. Many schools do scoliosis screening tests. If they don't, I know pediatricians generally do. For awareness, parents can pay attention to the child's overall posture and balance.
Once a patient is considered to possibly have scoliosis, then that patient is likely referred to a pediatric orthopedic surgeon, and that surgeon will then oftentimes take an x-ray to get a magnitude, to get a number of that scoliosis curve. Then the Scoliosis Research Society has given us some parameters used across the board. So if a curve is between 0 and 25 degrees, then typically those patients are just being observed and not necessarily starting treatment. At 25 to 50, then we start orthotic intervention or bracing during that time. And then anything above 50, then the conversation might turn into, does this curve require surgery?
If you can stop the progression of scoliosis with the brace, in some cases even correct that scoliosis or reduce the curvature of scoliosis, then I would have to say that I would consider that a win for everybody involved.
Many parents and patients alike may be unaware that non-surgical treatment is available for children with scoliosis. In fact, with proper brace wearing compliance and education, success is completely possible.
With bracing as the solution, it prevents long-term side effects from surgery. They're not going to have to deal with scars from surgery, any discomfort from the hardware that would be implemented into the spine. The bracing options available nowadays are offering a lot of different solutions for each child. I can't think of a good reason to not explore bracing first.
Brace compliance is the key to success. I like to say this is a marathon, not a sprint. We're in this for the long haul, and typically treatment time can be anywhere between 12 months and 4 years. So you can imagine that if you're wearing a brace every night for 4 years, you're gonna need a break every now and then, and that's just realistic. They just need to be able to have a sleepover with a friend or, you know, going on vacation with their family. So I give everybody 2 times a month not to wear their brace, just for a little breather from having to be confined in the brace.
If you were faced with any type of medical treatment, if you don't follow the treatment, if you don't take the medication that was prescribed to you, then chances are you're not gonna have good results with that treatment.
We place these compliance monitors inside the brace so that when we see them, they're going to report to us and say, I'm wearing the brace, let's say 16, 17 hours a day on average because of my activity schedule. And then I can also print a report to say, yeah, that's what the report is showing me as well. Or it might be showing me that, gosh, we're really only wearing it 12 hours a day, and how can we help to increase the time that you're wearing the brace so that we can get a better successful outcome of your treatment.
For bracing for scoliosis, we're trying to maintain and stabilize as the patient continues to grow and develop so that that curve doesn't progress.
So we have basically two different categories. We have nocturnal bracing, which is nighttime bracing, and full-time bracing.
Nocturnal bracing is a brace where between 8 to 10 hours a night, and you're gonna be wearing that brace in the privacy of their own home. And full-time brace wear is going to be 16 to 18 hours a day. So they're taking the brace, so they're wearing it to school, in and around their daily life. So it's two very different experiences.
We just want to make sure that we're doing the best we can to make sure that brace is going to be effective.
With so many bracing options, it's important to have the best knowledge and craftsmanship available for the patient. Spinal Technology is an expert in all types of scoliosis bracing. Their technology incorporates over 30 years of experience and customizable knowledge to support their patients' needs.
Spinal Technology is an industry leader in custom spinal braces, custom scoliosis braces for idiopathic scoliosis. We provide trauma support for all of our customers. We also offer on-site training, educational courses, in-brace x-ray evaluation over the phone, where if you've got an in-brace x-ray where you haven't achieved the correction that you were looking for, or the parents or the doctor, somebody wants a little bit more correction in the brace, they can call our toll-free number. They would reach one of the scoliosis specialists there, and we would review that x-ray and offer up any sort of solutions that we can come up with. There's at least 100 years worth of expertise in each one of those buildings. Customer service is something that we pride ourselves on. There's always a person on the other end that you're trying to take care of, and that's all you want is the best for that person.
Over the last few years, one of our major priorities has been expanding on and developing much more robust educational program so we can deliver and bring our knowledge and expertise to medical professionals, orthotists, as well as students.
The Providence brace is a nocturnal scoliosis brace. When you lie down, the spine elongates. It also unloads the spine. You don't have gravitational forces fighting against the correction process.
So the Providence is a hypercorrective orthosis. We're trying to be more aggressive. We're not worried about reflexes and trying to stay in balance. We have all this ability to achieve far greater corrective results in brace. I don't think there's any doubt, but the Providence is the most recognized nocturnal scoliosis orthosis.
Spinal Technology is constantly developing new and advanced braces and tools. Their goal is simple: sharing knowledge and improving the quality of life for every single patient.
At Spinal Technology, we make many different braces. There are also braces that are needed for post-surgical or trauma, supportive braces for neuromuscular patients. Each one is custom to that individual. Our plans for the future continue to educate the practitioner, that our customers, along with parents, and giving them information so that they can make an informed decision when they're faced with the fact that their child needs to wear a scoliosis brace. What you're doing is helping somebody. You're making braces that hopefully improve someone's life, prevent them from having to go through surgery, and just be able to function better and have a better quality of life.
Everybody in that building looks at each one of these the same way and just wants to help that person and that family.
We just want to make sure that we're doing the best we can.
Success is possible. Talk to your doctor about bracing options and support organizations that further research in this area. Learn more at spinaltech.com.